Good morning students, welcome to New Era Global School online teaching class. Yesterday we have seen about the chapter 6 habitat and adaptation overall review. Today we will continue the same. So yesterday we have seen about the adaptations, right? So today we will continue the how adaptations in organs helps the animals for movement. So as you all know, the animals are consumers, so they cannot prepare their own food, so they are called consumers. So they need to move from one place to another for what? In search of food, water and shelters. And they also move mainly to escape from the predators. So here are some adaptations for movement. First one, it is the limbs. So most terrestrial animals, they will move with the help of their four limbs, right? So we also have the limbs, our two arms and two legs, they are called as a limbs. So like that, animals also have the limbs. The first two limbs, they are called fore limbs, and the back limbs, they are called hind limbs. So human beings, they have two upper limbs and two lower limbs for movement. And if we take the frog, they will hop around using their strong and long hind limbs, right? And if you closely watch the frog, they have the webbed feet because they are amphibian. They can live in water also. So with the help of the webbed feet, they will swim. And the birds, if you take the birds, the four limbs, they are modified into wings. Why? To fly. And they also have the hollow bones because for flying, the body weight should be lightweight. So these hollow bones, they help them to fly. And then fins and flippers. So we will have this mainly the aquatic animals. Fish, they have the fins to swim in water. Aquatic mammals like dolphin and whales, they will swim with the help of the flippers. So these are the organs that help the animals for movement. And then adaptation in breathing organs. How the breathing organs helps the animals for adaptations. First one, it is called spiracles. If you see some insects like cockroaches, grasshoppers and houseflies, so in their body parts, a small holes will be present. The small holes, it is called spiracles. How they are useful? So by means of the spiracles, these animals will breathe. Air enters through the insects by means of these spiracles. And then fish. Fish have gills to breathe. You know, have you seen the fish? Near the eye part, gills will be present there. When a fish breathe, it will swallow the water. How? By means of the mouth. And the extra water, it will be removed by using the gills. So when the water passes through the gills, the oxygen present in the water, it will be taken by the blood vessels in the gills. So by using these gills, the fish will breathe. And then lungs. So we human beings, we have lungs to breathe. So like that, animals like reptiles, birds and mammals, they breathe through nose. So by means of the windpipe, the air will move inside and then to the lungs. Here the oxygen will be absorbed and it is distributed into blood stream. And if we take the skin, frogs and earthworm, these two animals, they will breathe by using their moist skin. So as I before told, the frog, it is an amphibian. It breathes through lungs when they are present on land. When they are present on land, they will breathe through lungs. And when they are in the water, they will breathe through moist skin. Okay. And here are some special adaptations. Okay. So how these special adaptations help the animals to survive? First one, it is called migration. Have you heard the word in CSS? This migration in social science. Migration means moving from one place to another. So people, they will move from one place to another. Why? In search of job, in search of their business. So they will be traveling. Like this, some animals, they also migrate from one region to another. So why they are migrating? Mainly to escape from the climate, in search of the food, or for their reproduction. Mainly for these reasons, these animals are migrating. So let us discuss that. So migration is the seasonal movement of animals from one region to another. So animals migrate mainly to find the suitable climate in search of food. If you take the birds like Arctic terns and pintails, they will migrate during the winter season. So during the winter season, they will migrate from one place to another. And if we take the insects like locust and certain type of butterflies, they will migrate long distance, mainly for search of food or for the reproductions or for collecting the honey. They will travel long distance. Wild beast, they migrate to regions where the food is available in plenty. So these animals, where the food is available, इसको ज़्यादा खाना खा मिलता है वो जगह पे वो migrate होता है. And then fish like salmon and turtle, they will migrate thousands of miles. Why? Mainly to lay the eggs. For laying the eggs, they will migrate even 1,000 miles. So this is the special adaptation. First one, it is called migration. And second one, it is called camouflage. What do you mean by the term camouflage? Have you seen the chameleon? According to the surroundings, they will change their color, right? Why? Mainly to escape from the predators or to find the food for them. So according to the surrounding color, they will be changing their body color. It is called camouflage. So let us discuss now. Some animals, they have the ability to change their body color. Why? To match their surroundings. So it is called camouflage. So mostly the body covering of some animals, they blend with the surroundings. Why? Mainly to catch their prey or to hide from the predators. So mainly for these two reasons, they will camouflage themselves. And then mimicry. It is not the definition of camouflage. It is a form of camouflage. That is, the animal looks same in shape and color to the non-living object, or it will be same looking like another animal. For example, if we say take a leaf insect, okay, it will look exactly like the leaf. Okay, so animals' mimicry is a form of camouflage. That is, it is the close resemblance of an animal in shape or in color to the non-living object or another animal. Why they are doing like this? Mainly to protect from the predators. So very best example, leaf insect look same like a leaf, and harmless hoverfly, they mimic the wasps or bees. So these are all the examples of mimicry. Then hibernation. So what do you mean by the term hibernation? For some animals, during winter season, the food may become scarce because they can't able to find the food in winter season. To avoid this condition, they will start doing hibernating. So hibernating means it is a long sleep that helps the animal to save energy and also to live in winter season without eating. So during that time, how they will get the food? So their body parts, they have the fat. Extra food will be stored in our body as a fat. So these fat, they provide energy for hibernating. So which animals will do hibernating? Bats, bears and snakes. So let us see now, see the paragraph. So during the severe winter, food becomes scarce. That is, the food, finding the food is difficult. So thus many animals, they have difficulty in finding enough food. So they solve this problem by hibernating. So hibernation, it is a long sleep that helps animals to save energy and to survive the winter without eating. So the animals prepare for hibernation by eating extra food which get stored as body fat. This fat is used to provide energy while hibernating. Example, bats, bears and snakes. These are all the examples. And then estivation. What do you mean by the term estivation? The same, hibernation only. But in hibernation, animal will sleep in summer. Sorry, in winter. But in estivation, animals will take a long sleep during summer season. So estivation, it is a long sleep-like state. Why the animals are sleeping in summer? Mainly to avoid the extreme heat. You know, during summer, the temperature will be very hot. So to avoid that extreme heat, the animals will do estivation. So what they will do? So they will bury themselves into the deep ground where the soil is moist. Examples of animals that estivate are earthworms, snails, frogs and toads. They come out of estivation when the weather is favorable. So when the weather is suitable for them, they will come out from that place. So it is called estivation. So we have completed our 6th chapter. So overall review I am giving. What are the topics we have seen? First we have seen about the habitat. The habitat means where a animal lives nature. There are two types of habitat are there. What are they? Terrestrial animals and aquatic animals. Terrestrial animals means animals that live on land. Aquatic means animals that live on water. Terrestrial ka example we have seen grassland, mountains, forest, desert, polar regions. And then water, we have seen saltwater habitat and freshwater habitat. Then we have seen what is an adaptation, how the adaptations helps the animals to survive. Then by means of the breathing organs, by means of their movement, body scales, wool and fur, the animals are adapting themselves. Then we have seen some special adaptations like estivation, hibernation, camouflage, mimicry, then migration. So these are all some of the special adaptations that helps animals to survive. So just go through this topic. Tomorrow, by tomorrow, I will send some questions to you. Try to solve it by yourself. See you, students. Take care.